Okay, Mr. YouTube personality.
That's me. Well, we have some new student workers that haven't seen all the AMT facilities yet, so we're going to show all the facilities to them. But also, kind of exciting, the AMT program has a new facility that's all set up and ready to go now, and I haven't even seen it yet, so Jared, the AMT director, is going to show us all. So we're going to go on a bit of a tour today.
Woohoo! Hi. So close. Well, let's go.
I just never heat it.
Want to come all the way through?
No.
Howdy.
What's up, dude? How are you?
Hey,
how are you?
All right.
Good.
So you guys just came in through our classroom. We're just finishing up class now. In the classroom, we'll do instruction, and then we come out here, and this is where all the hands-on happens. Right now, we're doing engine teardown. The students will come in and do a full engine teardown, repair, replace on the engines and things like that. And then we just got these bad boys in, which are our prop stands that we had custom made for the classes. This prop, you can add air to it, and it will feather the propeller just like it would if you added oil pressure in flight. So it simulates the action of the hub and the prop in flight. And those are pretty new. But we go through a lot of different stuff here. We also have the main rotor head there and
rotor blades.
Some of our aircraft are out there that that white piper runs. They'll run that when they pull the engine off of that, put it back on. And then we have a lot of these. These are trainers. And this is a full turbine fuel system. And this trainer will function. We'll plug it in, turn it on, and the instructor can come into the back. And there's a little box back here that says fault box. And while the system's running, the instructor can introduce faults into the system and simulate fuel failure in the system. There is 8 different faults that they can introduce on this one particular training. We have the same thing for anti-skid systems. We don't have an aircraft in our fleet that has an anti-skid system, so we had to buy one of these to simulate that. And again, it also has where we can introduce faults into the system while it's functioning. Our school is unique in the fact that we don't require students to have tools. We provide these toolboxes. We have 25 of them for the students to use throughout their duration here. So that saves quite a bit of money, anywhere from $1,000 to $5,000 that they don't have to spend. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. We'll bring aircraft. Everything in here is on wheels so that we can bring aircraft in. We can push aircraft out, much like a live maintenance shop. And we do, engine and transmission installations and removals on the helicopter over there, depending on what class is in here at what time. And then the classroom for instruction, we just kind of walk through, but.
All right.
Get it over, fill it.
You guys want to follow me?
Holy moly.
We're going to go real slow. It's my kids. They turn everything hot.
65, 75.
Yeah, for pilots, you guys sure are slow.
Aren't we always?
I was talking mentally.
So was I.
What I should do is I should drop an F-bomb every other word, so it makes it that much harder.
Hey, look at that nasty old trailer.
We should set it on fire and then film it.
Can I shame Andrew a bit?
Yes.
You can always shame Andrew.
So we went to Three Peaks yesterday. He's like, it's only going to take 10 minutes. And then I was like, we've been driving for 25 minutes.
You drive it like 5 miles an hour.
So you're the people that make me lose my mind.
$100 on gas a month.
You know what she does?
To $350.
She gets up in the morning and she thinks, I wonder how many people I can drive 20 miles under the speed limit in a no passing zone and make them lose their mind today.
Mm.
Set up, go.
Wow.
I'm off.
Okay, so this is precision aligned. Leasing some space in here. Our classroom's over
here. Really?
Fire away.
So this is the classroom space, and this is also some space for our electrical lab over here. If you look behind you, there's some of the boxes that the students have to build up and put switches, lights, and breakers in, and then hook them up to power and run them. And then there's some more of those trainers, oxygen trainer, a de-icing trainer. So this BO-105 we use to do advanced electrical wiring. There's a door in the back that we roll this out to and do compass swings with. Everything in here, wire buildup, our students have done so far. They ripped everything out and then just kind of rebuilt it. So this is our composites lab, and we'll run honeycomb, carbon fiber, and Kevlar composite buildups here. And then the students will do the composite buildup, and then part of what they have to do is the instructor will come and damage it, and then they have to repair it. This program is going to grow. We have a couple of grants out right now. We're trying to double the size of this and double what we do with this. This was donated by Cyberjet. Our students get to do a lot of riveting on this thing. Students will do sheet metal projects. Let me see if I can find them. They'll start, this is a first time thing that they'll start with. So every piece that you see in here, they have to bend, they have to build, they have to rivet. We have some really nice ones, but so that's our space over here. So a compass swing. So it's just basically testing to make sure your compass is showing north the way it's supposed to be. You take it outside and there's a bunch of stuff that happens. Okay, so that is a sheet metal bender, and that's a shear. If you want to bend it, so the students actually have to calculate how much metal you lose in that bend. So every time you bend, the metal expands on the backside and shrinks on the inside, and so your piece is no longer as long as it was before. K factor, I think it is. And that's part of this training, is they learn how to bend it and then how to determine how much of that bend they lose. So those are called clecos, and they go in and they hold the metal together when there's no rivet in there. So they simulate a rivet, and then you can rivet all around it and then pull this out and rivet that hole. It keeps the assembly together. So this is a project, this is the first project that they do. They're basically taking two pieces of metal, laying out a proper rivet pattern, drill it, and then they're gonna rivet it. And then it gets more and more complicated as the semester goes on, where they do bends and they do all kinds of different stuff. Then they have to fabricate different types of pieces. But this is where it starts. Hey, you guys should have that, where you have the turkey sound every time I curse. Every time there's a dumb joke, you go. that's it. That's all I have over here.
Thanks for showing us, Jared.
Yeah.
Where's the golf clap?
That's all I got. Cool. Andrew.
Do you have feelings?
Not really. Shall we pitter-patter?
Let's get at her.
All right, you guys need to go anywhere else before I drop you back off at your work?
I mean, if you wanted to go buy us coffee, that's cool.
Okay.
I'm just kidding. No, I can't drink coffee this morning. I got dentist appointments today.
Like, swish around some vinegar in there before you go in here.
Whoa.
Oh, is it a
garlic?
Everything you're like. I thought my appointment was at 8. Sorry.
How do my teeth look?
I ate some
shiitake mushrooms.
Most days I feel like I'm 12. Maturity level of a 12-year-old.
Alex, did you know that cemetery is famous?
Why?
Because people are dying to get in there.
There's a dad joke for you.
Boom.
Wow. Robbie with the zinga.
He got a zinga out of that one.
Ah, truck.
Am I driving too fast? What? He's like, oh my God. Mario Andretti over here.
Hey, thanks for nothing.
You're welcome.
It's time to learn about another person's call sign. Hey, Andrew.
Yeah.
You're a videographer, and you have a call sign. Somebody asked me the other day about why this is on your door, and it has to do with your call sign. Why don't you tell us about it?
Well, my good friend Michael Maurer, director of the aviation program, was kind enough to buy me this lovely poster when this movie came out, after having gotten the name Dora. And that came about because I'm the kind of responsible person that when they go out on a hike in the middle of nowhere, I'll let you know where I'm going. So I'll leave an exact footpath, trail of where I'm going.
You mean a map?
A map, yes. The Dora map. So that's how it was deemed. I was doing a hike out in Escalante. What hike was it? Reflection Canyon. And it's a pretty remote hike. We were going when it was just starting to warm up, so dehydration could have been an issue. So I told everybody where I was going, printed out a little map of the Reflection Canyon Trail, like a satellite image, and then path that we were taking just in case something happened to us. And because I left the map, I now have that call sign.
When's the last time you left a map for somebody?
Probably a while. I don't hike as much as I used to, unfortunately.
Can you sing any of the Dora the Explorer songs? Are you sure?
But you can, and I can film you doing it.
Well, thanks. This has been another exciting episode of What's Your Call Sign?
Very exciting.
I took the pictures out of my thing because I thought they weren't professional.
Oh, come on.
That's even better.
It's me with a thing of, like, for can, I put me with a thing of baked beans.
Why'd you take that out?
He had the term squawk the can, and he had one of his chickens next to his cans.
Why did you take those out? Yes, please.
That's what I said.
Okay.
Oh, brother.
Who has never been to one of these before? Who's a brand new employee? Come on out here.
We actually had to have a tie breaker, but this month, how are you? That's weird. It's this guy. It's Josh. Josh Lindau is our mechanic of the month. Josh, always willing to help. He's always learning new stuff. He is awesome. Probably the best sheet metal man on our team, and you know, and he's got a cool hat. That's
all I got.
Thank you.
So this month we've got someone that's been working really hard.
Preston Rivera.
All right, so our guy is Preston Rivera.
I got two.
All right, so Hayden Iverson, because of flex block utilization and his high power in flying. So he's over flexed more and filled more blocks since we've started this 5-day weekend than anybody else on our team. There you are, bud.
I do have, well, I have a boy.
Admin. I forgot about admin.
Admin. Okay, this person has done, this person is one of those individuals that does a lot of stuff behind the scenes, does some really amazing stuff, keeps Andrew largely in check. But she's done some great things with the Women in Aviation program and made it what it currently is and has set its future for growth and increased potential. Sam!
Do you have anything for the group, Mike?
Oh, is it my turn already?
Yeah, I'm mixing things up today.
Holy hell.
I know.
Is this a model of efficiency?
Something.
Hold on for a second. All right. We're going to start with temperature swings. So we're in that weird shoulder area of the season where we've got cold mornings, low DAs, and then the afternoon gets here and we have super high DAs. I think everybody's pretty good at figuring that portion out. But please remember that DAs next to the surface of the runway go way up.
That's what it's happening for. Good job. And Justin Miller. Justin, okay. Get a real close-up. How do you like that? It's a heritable forest. Get up in there. That's what I'm talking about.
Okay. Helicopters take the last four spots. That direction should be an empty spot, which maintenance uses for ground runs and whatnot, and then the fixed wings start and go the rest of the direction. So 1, 2, 3, 4 in, that should be as far as you're parking as helicopters, and fixed wing, you should leave one space.
Yeah, we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from Princess Parking working towards you guys.
Last week is the other day.
All right.
Literally every other day in the history of humankind is the other day, other than today. Tomorrow's also another day. So it could be the other day. Deep thinker.
What's up?
Well, that's it for us this week. We'll see you next time.
That works, right? That's a good outro.
It does.
Shout out to Jared, AMT director. That was a pretty cool tour. I didn't realize how awesome those facilities were, the new ones. So also shout out to Precision Align and Cyberjet for letting us use some of their space for our program and for the really cool pathway program that they've set up with us. And we'll see you guys next week.